Welcome back. So high erythritol in the blood causing heart attacks and strokes. Yes, this is what the latest research from the Cleveland Clinic is actually showing. So you may have heard of erythritol. Erythritol is a sugar alcohol found in all manner of keto foods and low carb foods. Erythritol is actually associated. So the Cleveland Clinic found that the erythritol is associated with an over-responsiveness of platelets to clotting. Now, we are constantly in a state of repair, especially in our vascular system. So this state of repair requires platelets coming together, coalescing to plug up the holes so that we're not going to bleed out. And the size of the clot needed, you know, really depends on the size of the wound. However, in people with elevated erythritol, that's sugar alcohol, the amount of clotting stimulus goes up 100% compared to the baseline needed to heal an area. So if you are at heightened risk for clotting issues, say you've had a heart attack, you've had a stroke, you're on birth control, you got diabetes, you're obese, you're drinking lots of alcohol, or you're eating a standard American diet, this can be a significant issue for you if you are indeed intaking erythritol. And it is everywhere, so you probably are. You not only are you walking around in an inflamed state with greater baseline potential for excess clotting if you have some of these conditions, but if you have challenges regulating blood sugar, meaning your glucose levels tend to be consistently above, say, 100 fasting, then you are creating within yourself excess erythritol. And this happens via what's called the pentose phosphate pathway. You don't probably need to know that, but you're just creating extra erythritol. If you indeed have these conditions, you have extra blood sugar in your bloodstream on a regular basis. So some will argue that the problem is not the crazy amounts of erythritol in these keto products people are consuming, but you know these sugar zealots will put the emphasis on Americans are fat, sick and nearly dead, and loaded down with metabolic disease. And so we're just creating all this erythritol endogenously inside ourselves. But this is not what the study showed. When participants consumed erythritol sweetened foods, their levels in the blood rose 1,000-fold above natural erythritol levels in the blood. Often erythritol is touted as this great sweetener because it's almost entirely unchanged as it goes from the keto cookie you ate through your gut into the bloodstream, you know, sent throughout your entire body, then out through your kidneys and into the toilet. Unfortunately, the process of not being metabolized deranges our gut bacteria, and then we now know leads to greater platelet adherence or platelet aggregation and clotting. So the keto cookies, the ice creams, the keto breads, keto bars, they are loaded down with this artificial sugar ingredient, and I think they should be considered pharmaceutical. As these babies, these keto ice creams literally are creating a super physiological change in your blood with a huge downside, which we now know is skyrocketing clotting risk. So it's true that erythritol is naturally found in fruits, but the concentrations in fruit and that come in your body are just insanely low compared to what you're getting in that keto cookie or that keto ice cream. Not only that, but that erythritol is naturally found, naturally formed. Whereas all this erythritol found in Truvia and, you know, these Lakanto monk fruits, these are unfortunately artificial. They're not extracted from fruit. They're artificially created in a lab. So you want to look at your protein bars, your protein powders, your green powders, and of course, any sugar-free keto-marketed food item you're consuming, as these babies are likely loaded with erythritol. That is my experience. And even those, you know, keto ice creams, you think, oh, good, I get ice cream. Man, often a typical pint of keto ice cream will have over 30 grams of erythritol. This is crazy. So I see, you know, macro counters promoting this stuff to my patients all the time as a way to fit a lot of sweet food into a macro counting routine. But time and time again, I see this backfire. If the food routine doesn't have at its literal baseline whole, real, nutrient-dense foods, you want to pass on it because it's going to leave you wanting. And as we can see in this case, it's got a pretty huge side effect profile to it. So raw honey, molasses, maple syrup, stevia, monk fruit, these are the sweets and the flavorings I would run to for health accumulation. You do need to watch monk fruit and stevia though, as they are often loaded with erythritol as carrier items when you want them in powdered form. In fact, the popular Lakanto monk fruit and Truvia stevia, these babies are essentially erythritol with just a little splash of monk fruit and stevia. Erythritol, think about it, has no nutrient benefit. It's basically us humans trying to find a shortcut to still consume highly processed foods, super convenient foods, and hopefully get away with it. But as we know, there are no shortcuts to health and vitality and vigor. Thankfully, there is health accumulation, which every one of us, every single day, can jump right into. And if you have not already been accumulating health, man, today's your day. You can go for it right here, right now. I'm Dr. Matt. I hope this is helpful and empowering and will serve to help you make better decisions for you and your family when you go to the grocery store. Please like, subscribe, send it to your buddies, and I'll see you next time.